Hello, Leos. This reading is for the 31st of March through the 30th of April. Yes, we have a lot of things that's coming up. The 1st of April is the start of the last quarter moon phase before we close out this cycle. The 8th of April is a total solar eclipse and new moon, right? 1st of April is also Mercury goes retrograde. Lots of good things coming. Let's go. Let's see what's in your cards, Leos. Let's see what's in your cards. All right, Queen of Swords. Here we also have Queen of Wands. Here we have the Nine of Pentacles, the Magician card, the Temperance card, and also the Strength card. You got a guardian angel watching over you. The guardian angel, they're sending a lot of messages through to you and just about how not to react to certain things. So, you know, how to balance things out. All right. So, you know, when the moon moves into Leo, that's your card right there, that it just lets you, reminds everybody, not just you Leos, but just people who have Leo in their birth chart, that all of our vulnerability is our strength, right? And so we have fire here, and then we have Mercury. So Mercury goes retrograde April 1st, right? So this is where you want to really, really slow down and see, you know, think about, look at things from a higher frequency. If something is causing you to be reactive, that's what source is saying. See the bigger picture of it, right? Here we had a Queen of Swords. We had a Queen of Wands. And we also have the Nine of Pentacles. Time is money. Everything doesn't deserve your time. Everything doesn't deserve your air. Like, everything doesn't deserve a response to it. So that's what your you know, you have a guardian angel that's helping you to see. So everything doesn't deserve your energy, in other words, right? From your throne, right? So you're starting out on your throne, Queen of Swords. So carefully vet your thoughts. You know, if it doesn't involve helping people to adjust their crown, sometimes it just doesn't, you know. The old you may have, you know, given some time to it. Would you say, yeah, I get 24 hours in a day. Do I really want to give even a second of my time to certain things? Nah, not really. Here we have the Chariot card. Here we have the Two of Swords, the Magician card. Here we have the Knight of Wands, the Star card, and then also the Three of Cups. Yeah, here we have the Chariot card. So Source is actually rewarding you for moving on, taking the high road, and just recognizing that you're a star in your own right, right? Ooh, you're a star in your own right. And so there's many stars in the sky. And so, like I said, some things don't deserve a response. And that's what you'll be rewarded. Like if you're at a crossroad and you say, okay, should I take the high road or low road? Should I give my time to certain things? You're carefully vetting your thoughts. Again, if it doesn't involve helping somebody to adjust their crown, you're saying, I need to stay away from it. Knight of Wands, right? I have a lot of great ideas I can put my time into besides that. Two of Swords here. So you want to take the blindfolds off. There's many stars in the sky, and people arrive at their purpose, pain in their purpose, different ways. So you may arrive to your purpose doing your thing, whatever you're doing. Like, because I see you're incredibly smart. Let's say you're a professor, right? And so you may be teaching a class that somebody else may be teaching the same subject, right? How they run their classes is not a comparison. The goal is to help other people reach their light too, inspire them to reach their light. So I definitely see that you're glad that the past is behind you and you're moving forward and just deciding, hey, I'm going to help people to, as it relates to two situations in particular, I'm moving forward. Here we also have the Wheel of Fortune. We also have the King of Wands. A lot of people are watching. You're leaving the past behind. Wheel of Fortune. We also have the King of Wands, the Temperance card again, Nine of Pentacles, and also the Judgment card. So you're breaking cycles, chains, and curses here, right? You have two guardian angels that's helping you to transition, right? And operating in your purpose, right? So we have this moon card, right? So you're definitely leaving the past behind, especially when you feel like people are harshly judging you. But I don't see you harshly judging anybody either, because I feel like you're saying to yourself, I want to be rewarded by Source. And a lot of people are watching you. A lot of people are watching you. They're paying attention to what you say, what you do. You're a hardworking person. There's definitely some energies that want to be in some kind of tussle, some kind of fight with you, like some kind of verbal altercation. They want to be like flame torching and going back and forth and all of that. And when you're in the light, you're going to have to pick and choose, because some people really want that 15 seconds of fame, not 15 minutes. They just want 15 seconds. So if you're on social media and you're posting, let's say, for instance, you read cards, you're posting videos and stuff like that, people want to go back and forth and argue with you. Let's say you're on, you know, you got to look at it from that standpoint. You just made somebody famous who didn't have to work for it because they just want to argue with somebody, right? So sources say you're going to have to be, if you disagree with something and sources telling you, I'm trying to help you on your journey, everything doesn't need a response. Some people know exactly how to push people's buttons, right? So, like I said, sources saying you're going to be aligning yourself with energies that are helping you. Here's the Wheel of Fortune. And you're going to feel very, very fortunate to be able to carefully vet your thoughts before you just blurt things out and just say anything, you know? And so, some of you all can drop some comments below and just name some times where you may have felt like, okay, I just wanted to just go straight in and respond to some stuff, but I said, no, I'm gonna hold my peace. I'm not giving any energy to it, because it'll actually bring attention to, you know, just the type of attention people want you to bring, you know, to it. You ever see online where people are trying to bait, you know, people who are famous online, they're trying to bait them into a back and forth, they, you know, making all kinds of comments. A lot of times people hire people to kind of sort of, you know, kind of vet their, you know, vet their comments. But a lot of times they may just say, I'm not answering that. What about, I got a purpose here, right? Here we have the Knight of Cups. So that's how you're going to save yourself. That is how you're going to save yourself. I definitely feel like you have a soulmate out there that's going to really help you with this, not going back into wilderness situations. Not going back into wilderness situation, and to stay away from that being reactive fast. You know, some people, they can't wait to pounce on people. They can't wait to say something. Oh, I don't like that new project. I don't like that so-and-so, and somebody should be doing it this way. Like, they're always in friction mode. They got to be in some kind of, until you are in your purpose and you're inspiring a lot of people, and people are coming at you left and right, right? You're like, wow, what? I'm trying to help people. I'm trying to help them find their flame, find their light. So yeah, source is going to send somebody else across your path who is also financially independent that's going to help you. And I see new and exuberant love coming across your path. So congratulations on that. But that's not your responsibility to sit there and fight, go back and forth with people, because you have a purpose, and that's what source wants you to focus on, your purpose. There's already enough people attacking other people online. So I definitely see you closing out cycles and moving on. Closing out cycles, leaving a circus behind and moving forward. So, all right, let's see what else we have here. Let's see what else we got going on here. See you moving forward. Yep, here we have the Five of Swords here. Two types of situations in particular, sources keep telling somebody to move on from. Stop overthinking it, stop talking about it. Every time you talk about it, you get upset and get frustrated. And you're giving people ammunition. Here we have the Strength card, the Ten of Pentacles, the Five of Wands, the Three of Cups, and the Nine of Pentacles. And source is saying, hey, you're very unique. You got 999 here. And so you have a real chance of making a very rich legacy for yourself. And we're not just talking about financial rich. We're talking about really tapping into your strength and just allowing your vulnerability to, you know, come through. That's your strength. You know, there's a lot of strength in your vulnerability and just saying, you know, certain things kind of get to me, right? That's an opportunity to, as you're closing out this cycle, write those things down, cleanse by fire, burning bowl, right? That's right. That's going to be your smooth stone in this David and Goliath situation. Whenever I have negative thoughts, you know, I'm in the light about it. I'm in the light about these. Let me get away from these negative thoughts. We got 9 and 9. Let me not talk about it because it'll come out on somebody else. You know, that's praying for you, and it'll come across as you are the energy that preys on people's perceived weaknesses and people's sensitivity, right? So again, here we have the Three of Cups. So I definitely feel like somebody is saying, you know, you and somebody are like, I'm glad the past are behind me with these two types of situations, and I'm moving forward. So good stuff, good stuff, good stuff, good stuff. So the moon is currently, I believe when you watch this video, it'll be in Capricorn. So let me give you the questions for the moon in Aquarius. First question is, what can you do to use your passion for serving on a large scale? The second question is, are you creating space for yourself to connect with your inner alchemist and innovator? Third question is, are you ready to think outside the box and delete old beliefs and rules to write your own? The fourth question is using technology a drain or gain for you? And then last but not least is, are you ready to start a group in your community to initiate and create positive change on a local or global scale? And then what could the focus be? Those are just meant to be thought invoking. That's it. They're optional. You don't have to write them down. You can create your own, whatever, right? But as you're moving through these phases, you want to see what grinds your gears, like really what upsets you, and is it affecting other areas of your life where you can kind of sort of say, you know what, I need to focus on something else, because there's a lot of people that's watching you. A lot of people are saying, or have been saying, that you have a temper. And where did that temper come from, right? So you have the gift of deja vu, remembering the future. You know, like, okay, I feel like I've been in this position before. I already know how the outcome is going to be. So before I get upset and get frustrated, let me toss that into a Bernie bowl. That's the solution. Let me toss it into a Bernie bowl. Make this thing ritual, a spiritual experience. Let me toss it into a Bernie bowl. Or if I can't get to a Bernie bowl, let me at least write it down. Let me toss it into a Bernie bowl, release it. I'm not giving people 15 seconds. Not even 1 second of fame. I'm not going in and going off on people, right? So you have the gift of clairvoyance. You see things clearly, right? So somebody misses you. Your enemy's plan backfired. They wanted you to go off on somebody. Angel Uriel, the angel of prophecy and wisdom. So, you know, is watching over you. Yeah, absolutely. So adjust your crown and love up on yourselves more and always bet on you. Somebody secretly has a crush on you, child. We're not even going to get into that. You know, good and well. Whoever has a secret crush on you, like I said, you're too busy working on yourself. You do not care. I mean, I don't know that you care or not, but I feel like you don't. So let's go ahead and see what else, some other messages we have from your loved ones on the other side. You do have a lot of ancestors around you that's really, really trying to help you to move through this rite of passage. And also, you know, helping you to go through this breakthrough, you know. And also they're passing down a lot of wisdom to you. Somebody's just going to say, hey, look, this is I'm a still divine being of light who's had human experiences, and that's that. It's not my way or the highway. You can't stop somebody from trying to, you know, get up under your skin, grind your gears, upset you, frustrate you. Here we have milk and butter, right? So 25. So let like the silk off one's flesh. I am the giver. I am your eternal. And we're talking about source, right? So 25. So, yeah. So I feel like what really kind of sort of upsets somebody looking at the cards here, which you may have experienced from the past, is you feel like people judge you. Don't create something in your mind that's not really there. Unless somebody's saying, you know, I'm whatever. Don't even give it any energy. None. No energy whatsoever. People talk about people online all the time. Detachment. So with detachment, you finally feel whole inside. With or without the fulfillment of a particular desire, ironically, that's often when it's fulfilled. That's right. So somebody has love coming across their path, right? And so again, people are watching you. People are trying to see how you handle certain things. Some people may think that, hey, okay, if they're really over their ex love interest, since somebody's ex is still in love with you, why does it get you so upset? Why does it get you that upset if you're really over something, right? If you're not that person's friend anymore, why does it get you so upset? Why are you so bothered? And so people are looking out and watching that and just saying, there's a thin line between love and hate. Like love and hate, what's really going on? So protect your energy. Learn how to use that burning bowl. Take your power back. Take your power back. 30. So I am imaginative. So you are an original, innovative thinker and an excellent communicator. You have great talent for using and creativity, using your creativity to convey your ideas, and your optimistic attitude has an uplifting effect on others. So let me read this again. You are an original, innovative thinker and an excellent communicator. You have a great talent for using creativity to convey your ideas, and your optimistic attitude has an uplifting effect on others. Okay? Let's see if we have affirmation card. Yeah. So yeah, as we're moving towards this total solar eclipse, right? We're going to have 5 eclipses this year. We have a lot of planets that's going to retrograde this year. Everything doesn't deserve your attention. Certainly not a reaction, right? A response sometimes is no response. You know what? The way I'm going to respond to it is tossing into a burning bowl and I'm going on about my life. Here we have affirmations for acceptance, saying a prayer or whatever you're going to write on your sheet of paper and toss it into a burning bowl, but you're releasing it. Cleansing by fire. I accept myself as I am. I accept what is without resistance. I have the power to choose my actions. I have the power to create change. I practice patience with myself. I am loved. I am not alone. I am at peace. That is what I have for you. Continue practicing detachment and not giving, you know, whatever energy, giving into certain energies. And that's how source is going to reward you. That's how source is going to reward you. That's what I see for you, and I'll see you in the next reading. Bye.